it's not only a bad hair day, it's a bad lipstick day. Hi, everybody. How you doing? Welcome to Stamper Start Studio. Stamp Studio, whatever. Oh, golly. I think I need to go back to bed because this was not the day to go in. This was not the day to hit the snooze button. I am so thankful that you're here. Let me put some glasses on and just not let, you know, if you think I'm looking down here so that I'm looking at myself, well, that's not the truth. The dog's down here as usual licking my ankles. Yep, because he can get away with it. Oh boy, if you think you're going to have a good time today, well, believe me, I'm going to do my best to make that happen. And so if you have some friends you think that could use a laugh today, make sure that you invite them, because you might want to tag them down in the comments, because yeah, it's just one of those days you just have to laugh. I mean, it's a good day, don't get me wrong, but it's a good thing I didn't hit that snooze button. So I'm just going to say hello to Millie over here in Yuba City, and Diane, Marcy's down in Texas, Kathleen's on the East Coast, aren't you, Kathleen? Arlene, Kathy in Florida, oh my goodness, no hurricane here, but tornadoes abound. Oh my goodness, Kathy, golly. Jackie's down there in Florida as well, and I hope you're okay. Usually she's okay in these things, but you know, I mean, you just never know. If they're watching me, there is either nothing to do, and they all get to stay home from work, or yeah. Tony's in Tennessee. Connie, Sheila, yes, your stuff went out today. In fact, I'm going to put a picture of it later of all the boxes, because we got some of them out yesterday and then the rest out today from the sale this weekend. Susie, yep, hi, haven't seen you in a while. Paula, Kathy, and you know, the list goes on, and I would love to address each and every one of you. And if you're new here, welcome, and if you're coming back, you know you are my people. Okay, since he's here, hold on, I have to tell you that the Wednesday after the second Tuesday is probably the hardest one of these for me to do. Now, the way it worked was that last night, Stamp Club came over and we had a great time. But guess what? They got to do some of the things that I've been showing you over the past weeks. What are you looking at? You're supposed to look at me or them. How about that? Yes, me or them. So, since you're here... And I promise to have a laugh. Let's see. Hold on. I have to bring this picture in because I wasn't able to earlier. I pray that I brought it in. If not, let's see. Hold on. I'll find it really quick. It's not there, so I know where it is. It's right here. Of course, they're all coming up. There we go. Sorry about that. Okay. It's going to be one of those days, okay? So here, I want you to caption this picture, okay? I want you to caption this picture. This last night, Stamp Club came over, And okay, I hope you have sound now, because you know, it's like about at least 30 seconds later I see this, but boy, am I glad you're paying attention. Anyway, I want you to caption this picture, okay? And the caption is not, "We have no sound." Yeah, it's because when that beginning thing came up, it automatically mutes my microphone, you know, while I'm getting ready. So anyway, I want you to caption this picture, and I'll tell you what happened. Last night, well, first of all, I looked at the camera, or not the camera, I looked at the what did I look at? I looked at the calendar wrong, and I thought last night was our mystery hostess that we do at the end of all of our stamp clubs. And so I thought that it was my turn to, you know, I was gonna make, I got, well, I had acquired a really nice apple pie from the pumpkin patch. And then what happened was we put it in, and you know, it says to put it on a cookie sheet. And so, yeah, caption this picture. Just write it in the comments, whether you're on YouTube or on Facebook. So we put it on one of those cookie sheets that don't have. I'm gonna start putting these up. That don't have an edge on them. So what happens? But what happens? But the all the good stuff, because there was a lot of butter in this. It was a French apple pie, and the butter. Well, everything just kind of went over, and the house was all smoky, and it was just well, no. I put Kathleen's up there, but she I like this one. This one made me laugh. But anyway, when I went, after everybody left, when I went to try and get some of the stuff up, look at what happened. It just came up in one piece. So I went, "Grab my phone, grab my phone." Oh, this is a good one too, Paula. Paula's got one coming too. And so I had to take a picture of it. And then, you know, the dog, he was so good. He came over and he gave me his idea, you know, his little 2 cents worth. And I was so happy that he went and looked at the you know, he at least looked close to the camera, which is, oh, okay, I'm gonna put this one up, and then okay, we got one more, and then we're gonna cut to the whatever we are going to get up to today. But anyway, it was just one of those things that the house filled with smoke. Everybody came over, you know, and most of the smoke was gone. Cheryl was here when some of the smoke was here, and so it was just really interesting. And we don't use our oven so much. We have a golly, what is it? We have a Instant Pot, and we use the Instant Pot quite a bit, but you know, everything in all its time. So you know what? You know, Laura, that is a we oh, that's an idea. That's okay for all of you who don't know what you should do. Now, I know you're not supposed to put it on the bottom of the you're not supposed to put it on the bottom of the oven. I know that. But it's all gone now because it's a self-cleaning oven. But anyway, golly, do I look gray today, or is it just the, yeah, I'm over here. So if you think, when I'm looking down here, I'm looking to see what you say, and I really would like to feature what everybody says. And if you're new, please introduce yourself. But it just doesn't work out that way. You know, I have to look at everything because I'm the producer. He might be the director, but I'm the producer, and he's not in his director's chair. So Laura brings up a really good point. There's something about Stamper. You know, I started taking pictures of him when he was very, very young, and I learned really early, and I want you to learn this too. Please try your best. Don't use a flash on a dog because, it, you know, then they're never going to want to look at you when you're taking pictures. And so that's why Stamper frequently will look right into the lens, not sometimes not knowing, but because I've never worked with him enough to where, okay, you only get a treat when you get, you know, look in the lens. But he usually looks towards me. It's really best if either Cecil or I are in front of the, you know, are behind the camera. But don't use a flash because they don't, you know, then they're not going to want to look at it. And so you got to make sure that you have good light. But all this time, because he's such a effervescent dog, he, you know, he's always gotten treats for calming down. Well, what's calming down? Calming down is kind of serious because unless he's been out running, he's not going to sit here like this, you know, smiling. Because most of the time when dogs are smiling, they're either excited about something or they've been out running. Right. And so they tend to open their mouth, drop the tongue out, you know, it looks kind of like a human smile. So anyway, that's my little thing. Yeah, I don't know what it is because I have the exact same lighting here. And yeah, I just, it's funny. I don't know. I'm just kind of, let me see if I can fix that really quick. But, you know, you're not here for me. You're here for what I'm going to show you, right? That's not even any better. Advanced settings. Okay. Whoa, advanced settings. Color intensity. Let's turn the color. Whoa, that doesn't help me. I'm still gray. It's probably the white balance. And that is not going to help me either. So, hey, let's just figure Anne's a little gray today. And we'll just call that good. But, I, you know, hey, thank you. No volume. Well, wow, if I, you know, I can turn that up. Hold on. Now I'm going to ask Kathleen, you know, because Kathleen's pretty smart about this stuff. Am I loud enough? I mean, I know sometimes when I play it back that I have to turn it up a bit, but, yeah, everybody else is hearing me, so it could be that you have to turn your computer up maybe a little bit higher than you're used to, or your phone. I don't know. So I'm going to show you something today that I, you know, we'll show it later. But first of all, I have to show you what Cindy did last night. Oh my goodness, I haven't even focused the. I told you, you know, at 9 minutes too, I was in my underwear. How about that? Oh golly, you know, TMI. Let's pick this one. Now you see all my little. Look at what Cindy gave everybody last night. Is that nice or what? I do not know why I'm gray. Nothing's changed here. Nothing's changed. Let's see if that makes a difference. Nope. Oh, make my day. Well, anyway, and look at this. So she made these, and this is off a retired stamp set. But that isn't that cool? And then she went and this is white chocolate peanut butter. But look at these are on the back. So if you see any of these, and if you have this, that's great. I mean, look at, she stamped on both sides. And so, like, yeah, Cindy's great for, she goes and she usually has a thing at church, you know, when we do the trunk or treat. And so here, let's go. Now you'll see everything. So today I'm going to, you know, we're all inspired by something. And I happen to run across a video. It was my friend Billy's, well, she's not a demonstrator anymore, but she shared her first Facebook Live that she did. And I went, you know, I want to try that. And then So I'm going to try it with you, and we'll do it maybe just a little bit different because, you know, that's the way it works. But if you have a leaf stamp and an aqua painter, that's going to be great. Yeah. Now, what you could do is go and tape this down. That would, boy, I would love to tape that down because this is a pristine piece of cardboard here, and I'd like to keep it that way. Hold on. Let's see. If I tape it down, though, this is not the one I'm going to use. This one's 3.5 inches square. It's watercolor paper. It's, Yeah, Patty, you know what? It might look like the light is out, but it's not. So I think maybe if I rebooted the computer and started over again, maybe that would work. Okay, so I started to grab some of these, and then my phone went off to tell me, oh my goodness, it's 1:01. Okay. We liked these colors before. You know, I put all the Cajun Craze, Mossy Meadow, and Blackberry Bliss. We may not use all of those, but I have a feeling I'm going to. And I'm going to hold that thought because I'm going to run out and I'm going to get the stamp set I used. Hold on. It's just going to take a second. Woohoo! I told you it wouldn't take very long. Oh, golly, you guys really deserve something nice. Hey, who took advantage of that great sale we had for World Card Making Day? I mean, that was awesome, Possum. That was great. Now, I don't usually do this, but this time I think I might. Boy, I think my friend Cindy gets the prize for stocking up on the most Stampin' Dimensionals because, you know, we ran out of Stampin' Dimensionals and they'll be coming soon if you're on the back order list. I think I'm going to start with, this is where it gets hard. Shh, Kathy. Kathy, where, you know, I'm not going to be talking about that until I go and unbox my, oh, look at this. Yes. Okay. So if this happens to you, let's see if this works. You know, I like to lick the back of the stamp. I'm licking my finger and I'm going to rub it right there. We're going to see how that goes. Anne is wonderful. And Stamper's a good dog. Yep. See, look at it worked. Whoa, I think I would have been better with it. Doesn't matter if it's not right. I might have been better to stamp off. And this one I'm going to, whoa, got a little ink on me. Note to self. Usually putting re-inkers in the top works better. You'll get more color, but we'll see if this works like it did for her. Yeah, it seemed to really smoosh up more, but then it could have been her camera, you know. But I'm trying to smoosh this all the way through it. You don't have to stay within the lines, but it might be a good idea. Okay, bonus points if someone's got an order number for the aqua painters, because boy, I can remember when we got aqua painters, I just thought they were grand. Now, this is not the way she exactly did it. This part is. when she did it, she put so much water on there. It looked like there was no detail here. But, you know, I've got some really good cameras that, you know, it was her very first video. And let's see. Now, the secret to aqua painters is have a paper towel nearby, and then you just go and do this. Now, why do I say this? Because if you get in the habit of doing it on your grid pad, you are, if you get in the habit of doing it on your grid pad, you're going to one day accidentally put something down and it's going to have, it's going to be wet, and then your project's not going to be good. So there's certain habits that are good. Okay, now let's see how this works. This is the part that did not happen like I'm showing you. And I just thought, you know, I'll make all the mistakes for you. I'll make all the mistakes for you. I'm trying to think of which part would be this part. Now, I'm going to tell you a little secret. That's another good thing to think about is to go in. Since I've had green on this, and I might be mixing this up, before I close this, and because I've got water on this, I would go and, thank you, Susie. I would go and wipe that out before I go and use that again, because it's, you don't want to get green in your, I don't know, this isn't smooshing around as much as I thought. I should have, you know, it could be she didn't have Stampin' Up! Watercolor paper. It could have been she was using way more water than I was. Of course, she didn't do this thing. She just accidentally smushed a different color into the green. Because look at it, looks like there's a line there, and I'm like going, yeah, that's not the way God makes leaves, you know. I'm like, yeah, but I don't want to go, I'm trying not to go outside the line, even though there is no official ruling, you know, kind of like football, there is no official ruling that you cannot go outside the lines, okay? Boy. So, yeah. I'm going to go over here. We'll see if it works on this. I'm just going to have to smush more. Oh, see, it's starting. It looks like it. I like it. So much for my beginner's luck. See, with this, you can squeeze the barrel and you can get more water on there. But that's one reason why you might want to go and, whoa, okay, see what happens when you put more water on there? You get more color. This one looks more real to me. This one is very kind of dark, so perhaps stamping off would be a good idea. That might be a good idea. So let's try the smaller one. Okay, here's my question for you. Is this a silver dollar or is this a tree trunk? Not a silver dollar, a sand dollar. Is that a sand dollar or is that a tree trunk? I'll tell you what I think. Whatever you say is right, that's what I think. Okay, so I'm going to try this again. I'm going to have to move this so that I can get to my, whoa, grid pad. We'll try this. Yeah, and here's the other thing. I just went and I just recently did that Mossy Meadow. You know, re-inked it. Okay. I stamped that off first. Remember, I'm going to clean this up, right? Just all you do is wipe it until it comes clear. Because the tip, you might be able to see it there. See how the tip gets, it gets stained, but it doesn't transfer over. As long as when you're wiping it, it comes up clear. See, I stamped it off. You still have some. And when you're watercoloring, see, look at this, is starting to look like what hers did as far as how much, you know, like there were no lines. You couldn't see any lines. See, now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Everybody says tree trunk, but I the first thing I thought of was a sand dollar. Isn't that funny? But I think it's a tree trunk. But what's cool is we can use it for either one. Now, when you, like I've been starting to say, is that when you're watercoloring, I hate having that underneath the light. If you put a drop of reinker in there, you're going to get a much deeper color than you are with this. Hold on one second. This stuff isn't where it usually is. So it's just, like I said, I was in my underwear. Here, now you can really see. See, yeah, when she did it, even though I'm putting a lot of water on here, you couldn't see the lines. But she was using an old stamp set, but it was the same idea. But anyway, when you're watercoloring, if you smush the lid and get this, right? You're going to get a lighter tone. If you go and use a reinker, then that's different. You're going to get a different. I was just going to put that down the middle. So I'm just up here making mistakes for you, and then I'll come in and I'll show you what we're coming into. If you think I can do better at this, I invite you to come back. And if you're on, and see, because, you know, where there's life, there's hope. At least that's what my mom used to say. And just if you're on Facebook, just type stamp this in the comments. That's how a lot of people got here right on time. See this? Wow, we're making a really interesting little leaf there. So see, look at, you can't see the detail over here anymore. Not so much. But we have really good watercolor paper. I know that. Of course, you know, I'm just a little bit biased. I'm going to put a little bit more down here. Once it's dry, you can stamp over it again. See, look at, see, wipe, wipe, wipe. Whoa, that's close. Wipe, wipe, wipe. Yeah, I think down here is about as close as I can get. I mean, look at, you can see everything in this. Oh, you know, that's why we put the pearls in your package. That's why we put the pearls in your package. Yep. Well, you know, it's just, yeah, I'm a night person. I can't help it. See, look at, that's kind of what you're going for. Kind of like to where you can make it look like you went and did a watercolor image yourself. I've been thinking of going to this venue where you can go and watch me create, but it would be in the middle of the night because that's when I usually get creating, and it just be a lot less formal. I've been thinking of trying that out, but golly, then I'd have to get dressed for that, and that's just, you know, not my nature. I think it needs some green down here, but I don't know. I think once it gets, well, let me put some more water on it. Whoa, squeak. Whoa, whoa, whoa. That is way too much water. I don't know if you can't see it. And if I tilt it so you can see it, but there's a lake on this thing. Okay, here, this is how I can, remember, clean that puppy. See what I mean? There's a lake on it. Whoa, okay, better. Now I could probably plop it on there, but boy, I mean, it was just like standing water. I don't want to scare any of you people down there in Florida. Oh, golly. Okay, I'm going to try one more. One more, one more. Now, I stamped this once. Oh, and I'm getting ink on my thing here. I'm going to stamp it off. Nope, this time I'm going to stamp it full strength. Okay, I went over it, the other one a little bit. But I'm going to bring some purple in there. I'm going to tell the truth. I may go and start a new one, because really I'm just hoping that I'm not going to like be good. See, look at this. It'll go outside the lines if you give enough water to it. And if you look on the other side, see, I don't know if you can see that. Oh yeah, there you go. A little bit right there. You can see where it's indented. It's in any place where I put a lot of water. Okay. Clean. Yeah, Millie, it won't be on, this venue is not on Facebook. It's a different venue. It's, and they have a totally different style. But here, I'm going to have to, these new ones, I know you can do it. Ugh. I know you can do it. Let's back this up a little bit here. Yeah, come on, let's see. Can I do it? I know I've done it before. Look at it. It doesn't, it's just harder to get that in there. I'd probably have to like stand on it with my elbow. You know, I'm going to tell you something. Here's the thought for today. And it's really about not letting yourself get in the way, right? Of doing something that you want to do. Because do you know that a year ago, I didn't want to do this because I know that I'm really not a clean crafter. You know, like you'll never come into my stamp room and go, oh, look at all the white cabinets and everything is put away. You know, there's nothing wrong with being that person. It's just not me. I mean, I'll even show up with a gray face. You know, I'm going to tell the truth. I planned this camera thing so it would hide parts of my hair that will not be visible tomorrow. yeah, I love you guys. You are my people. So, you know, Laura Ann, it won't even be on YouTube. It'll be a totally different venue and someplace you probably have never been before. I know Kathleen's been there. It's just a thought. I did a little test run just to see it, but I didn't really like do anything. But you know, I do things like 11, 12 o'clock at night. That's 3 o'clock in the morning on the East Coast. So, you know, oh, Susan, oh, I love you. So speaking of not tidy, some of you are getting, who purchased from me last night, or not last night, but last month, and Susan, you're one of them. I am a little short on my little prizes that I put in there, and so they're a little bit delayed. Some of them I had to delay them. Okay, I got to hold my mouth right for this one. So please, you know I'm going to be sending you something fun. Okay, let's get my gray head out of there. This doesn't have any water in it, but it's, let's see what it looks like with a little bit of purple in it. Ooh, I kind of like that. See, but you only want to use just a, that's right underneath the light there, just a itty bitty bit, because this is more, you know, more, concentrated than if you say, look at now, I got too much on there. Well, okay, we're making a different thing now. Okay, so much for that. That's not what I was going for. But hey, I'm here making the mistakes with you. I'm just glad that you're showing up and, oh golly. That doesn't look so bad. I like this one better than this one. Yes. Yep, Karen's got the right idea. Yes, Kathleen, I am thinking. Yeah, I'm thinking of doing that. Yep. Well, I've been thinking about it for a long time. But hey, back to my little thought. You know, don't let some little thing stop you from stepping forward. Because look at, there's so many of you that I would not have met if I hadn't done this. I mean, there's a lot of you that I would not have met if I wouldn't have started going live on Facebook. And I'm so glad that you keep showing up every week. And, you know, and some of you I've even met face to face, you know. And, you know, but I met you here on Facebook, just like, you know, my friend Cindy. We go to the same church. We have for like longer than I've known her. But where did I meet her? I met her at a craft fair. Look at, and if you would leave a little bit of bright in there, that's really better. See, that's what I think. These are just a little bit too flat. They looked really nice on the one that I saw, but, you know, it's like, whoa. It's like, you leave it to Anne. Usually I have beginner's luck, so it doesn't really scare me to try something new. Well, it does a little bit, but anyway, but just think of that. You know, if I would have let the fact that I have a messy desk behind me stop me, then I wouldn't have met all you, and it's really been a real blessing. And so, you know, if you're thinking of doing something, go ahead and try it. You know, like my only regret about becoming a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator is that I didn't do it when someone first asked me. Oh, look at just adding just a little bit of purple to that, Blackberry Bliss. I need like a little bit of yellow or something to lighten that up, or like maybe I can get my eraser out. No, there's no eraser on there. So somebody won the. Hold on, I'm gonna make that all the way around. Let's see. If you're thinking of trying this, make sure that your table is protected. I honestly haven't used my aqua painters in a long, long time. I used to just love them. Used to just love them. Oh, you know what? I really think you're right, Marcy. I think you're right. And there's nothing wrong with that. It's just the path, you know, but be who you are, because if, you know, I do me pretty well, whether you like it or not is a different story. If you're here, you must at least have a midline idea of it. But, you know, if I tried to be somebody else and have a clean thing behind me, then I would never get anything done. And so, yeah. So, hey, I think we got that one. Yep. Well, I like this one. This one needs, I think we're going to have to put some of the green in there or something, because it just looks, now it looks a little sad. Now this one looks enhanced and that one looks a little bit, I don't know. My mother sent me to oil painting lessons when I was a kid. The first thing I did was really good after that. Oh, maybe not so much. I'm not sure. So, and it's funny because I took a photography class before we got married, and I went out to the local community college and took a photography class, and I brought in some pictures that I'd done. Oh, I shouldn't have done this part. And at the end, the teacher told me, you know, you took better pictures before the class. And that was just reading the instruction booklet. So, yeah. So there you go. Wow. So those of you down here, and oh, See, Laura, that's exactly what somebody told me. They said, you know, it looks like you're actually using your stuff. And I went, oh, good. This needs more water here. I'm afraid to push too much water because it, okay, clean this off. Because of what happened last time with the pool. One thing about leaves is that, you know, they're supposed to be brown. So if you mix all the colors together and it goes brown, guess what? Well, they're supposed to be green, but at some point they turn brown. There you go. So just like with this, you know, just don't be afraid. Do it. Oh, I like that better now. This one, I don't know if there's anything that'll save that one. Yeah, crushed curry would be a good idea. Hold on one second. Yeah, the only problem is crushed curry, you know, it's usually you start with lighter and build. Make sure that you, oh, sorry. When you have these new ink pads, make sure that you click them shut because, see, like this one, you think it's shut? No, it's not. There, now it is. Well, yeah, that's exactly right. Oh my goodness. Huh, why didn't that show up? That's interesting. That's interesting. Now weird things are happening. Yeah, it was a fun time last night. Hold on, see, do I have ink on my hands? I usually keep my hands pretty clean, and I highly recommend that you wash your hands if you get them. If you have some, okay, I can tell that this is for this old style pad. It's not really old, but anyway, because I've got a little dot here, and if you have any of those little dots that we were selling last year, put them on your old ones and then you'll know, because when I replace this pad for this new style pad, then I'll replace the re-inker as well. I didn't do that for that reason. I did that for that reason because and by the way, you can mix these up, but if you mix them up, you will want to wipe it out if you use this for a palette. I don't know. I'm going to try this one because I like this one better. See, it's going to give it a yellow tinge. It's not going to necessarily see it. Yeah, it's going to give it a yellow tinge. It's not going to necessarily turn it yellow. And now it's making a liar out of me. Now, I wonder how this is going to. I'm going to go. I don't want to be just like, oh, here's an oval. Yeah, see, Paula? I mean, isn't that a cool idea? And then they get, and then they change the re-inkers, and they change the re-inkers, and they change the pads just right, and they quit making those enamel dots. I really liked them. I think I'm just going to let this one dry because I might be adding some more to it, but it just kind of gives it a yellow twinge, and I'm going to just go and clear this up, and now I'm going to try to blend them in this way. See if that helps with no, there's just water in here. See, look at, now we all learned something. You want to blend it, you just go and put more water on it. There you go. Now it really does look more yellow. Wow. Oh yeah, here, you know what? You could do this. I'd have to do it with a really small block. You know, these, a clean one of these especially, is really good if you just want, if you're going to be trying to mix colors, then you could put a couple colors on here and then just mix them up. And then you wash it when you're done. I have a hard enough time keeping them clean in between, in between stuff. So there you go. So I have a prize. I tried to give it away on Friday, but a demonstrator won it, and she didn't want me to spend the postage to send it to her, and I really appreciate that, because let me tell you, that postage man, he's getting my donation, that's for sure. Now, before you clean your ink pads, or not your ink pads, but your stamps, hold on one second. Hold on. I don't know that he's out there. But anyway, you do want to go and I have 3 stamp pad cleaners. You would think I would have one here. But it's out in the front room. It's out in the front room. Anyway, you would go and well, I'm going to get this together while I'm talking to you. Make sure that you stamp off, you know, before you go and put it into the, into the cleaner, because otherwise you are going to just go and just bring all that ink into your stamp pad cleaner, and you're going to have to clean it faster. But sorry, it's not there. So, hey, let's go and give away something. And what it is, it's diamonds. I'm giving away diamonds. They're right here. They're right here. Boop, diamonds. They're a girl's best friend. See, I even got one recently. You get one every 36 years. Did you know that? There's a new law out. So, here, let's go and winner, winner, chicken dinner. So, if you've been giving us some hearts, if you've been giving us some love, well, hey, I appreciate that, and they're going to count you. If you've been commenting over on Facebook, I wish I could bring the YouTube people in on this too, but that's okay, you can play next time. And then it doesn't matter how many times you're going to get your name in there, and you do have to be here. Oh, wow, we would like to go over your participant plan. Thank you so very much. So I guess I am going to have to find a new way of giving it away. Ah. We're going to go through everything. And now, you know what? We're going to go and look at all of them and just go put them in a pile. I'm going to count how many there are. I'm going to have Barbara, when she gets here, go and pick out a number. And we'll just go announce it. So, look on the dog's blog tomorrow, you know. But Laura Ann, what are you terrible at? Oh, making bows. Do you want to know something? My very first video that I really did on YouTube was how to make a bow. And it had background music, and it was only like a minute long. It wasn't my very first one. My first one was with the rub-ons, and it was so bad that I went and I had to go and, we need to hide that from humanity.
Yes.
So, hey, if you are thinking that you would like to join me sometime on another level, you really might want to think about joining our Master Stamper, which, hey, I did not see her here today. So I'm going to bring this picture up and see if I can. I'm going to bring this picture up and see if I can share it. I don't think that she will mind if I share it. Hold on. This is over on our Master Stamper, the private Facebook group, where people can go and share their own stuff. There's also the stuff that where I do the videos and the written instructions. But look at that. Isn't that a nice card that she did for her brother-in-law? I mean, I just love that. I haven't seen Kay here today, but she's Doodle's mom. Hold on, I'm going to cough. Hold on, I'm going to get a cough drop. Yeah, she's Doodles Bomb, and she does some really great work. But if you're thinking that you might want to join the Master Stamper, just type Master Stamper below, and if you're on Facebook, and we will get you in. If we've been doing it like 7 years, it's over 200 videos. Pip Todman over in England, which you met on a few other things. Just recently, she is going to be doing next week's project. I got another one coming up this week. And we would love to have you there. So thank you so very much for spending some time with me. I went a little 5 minutes over, but God bless you. I am just so happy to be one of your people. God bless.